Hello friends, this video on microbes in human welfare part 11 is brought to you by examfear.com. No more fear from exam. So now we are going to talk about microbes in biogas production. So now you gradually would believe that microbes are not always harmful. They are helpful in many of the cases. So till now we saw so many different things. They help in preparing medicines like antibiotics. They help in preparing so many household products like cheese, curd, etc. They also help in reducing environmental pollution by helping in sewage treatment. Now we will see how microbes help in generating new renewable sources of energy. That is how it helps in biogas production. Now let us first introduce biogas before we talk about how microbes help in biogas production. Now all of you would have studied about biogas in your junior classes as well, but let us have a quick recap. So let us start from the basics. What is biogas? So biogas is nothing but a fuel gas. It can be used as a source of energy. So it is a mixture, it is not a single gas, but a mixture of various gases like methane, carbon dioxide, etc. However, methane forms the major portion of it. So almost 65% of it is made up of methane. So mostly it is composed of methane. It is a renewable source of energy resulting from biomass. What is renewable source of energy? Which can be renewed over and again. That is, it can be cycled back. So you use it and then again in the environment it is cycled back. So nothing gets wasted. So renewable sources of energy, source of energy is obviously better because it doesn't add to environmental pollution. And secondly, it is derived from biomass. Now what is biomass? Now let us quickly talk about biomass. Bio means life, mass is mass. So something which is derived from life. So something which is derived from living organism. So from living organisms, biogas is actually derived. So biomass is nothing but fuel obtained from plant and animal products. Now plant and animal products, they all were life. And that is why the name has a bio before it, because these are obtained from plant and animal products. Now, plant and animal wastes like vegetable waste and sewage, cow dung and residue after harvesting crops, they are all decomposed in absence of oxygen to give biogas. So here you see the raw materials, they are all derived from living organisms. Whether you talk about vegetable waste or you talk about sewage or you talk about cow dung or you talk about the residue which is left after harvesting crops. And also if you notice, they are all in one way, they are all waste products. Like for example, this cow dung or vegetable waste, they are not utilized. They are just thrown off because they do not serve any purpose. So all these waste materials can be decomposed in absence of oxygen to create a new renewable source of energy, that is biogas. So that means also it is extremely good because the waste products in the environment can be utilized for something productive. This is also called as gobar gas. Biogas is also called gobar gas. Now you might be surprised to know this name, that why biogas is called gobar gas. So we will try to understand that as well. Now before that, let us see which microbe helps in biogas production. Now the microbes which help in biogas production is methanogens. As I said, methane is the most important component or constituent of biogas. So the bacteria which helps in the production of methane primarily are methanogens. So methanogens help in biogas production. So let us talk a little bit about methanogens. Now we have seen till now that different microbes produce different types of gaseous end products during growth. So methanogens are anaerobic bacteria, that is they do not require oxygen for their survival. So they can do without oxygen. They grow on anaerobic sludge during sewage treatment. So you remember in the sewage treatment, at the end of the secondary treatment, we saw that the sludge which was being produced, the activated sludge, a portion of it was recycled and the remaining portion was sent to the anaerobic sludge digesters. So who digested the microbes in that sludge? The anaerobic bacteria. So these those anaerobic bacteria were nothing but these methanogens. These methanogens are also found in the stomach of cattle So that is another place where you can locate these type of bacteria. So now the thing is, now you would have seen that by now we have discussed about so many different types of microbe which produces different types of things. Some microbes produce ethanol as a result of fermentation. Some of them produce lactic acid. Some produce methane gas. So the type of gas which is produced depends on the microbes, and it also depends on the organic substances which are being utilized. But for most of the bacteria, one important end product is carbon dioxide. So here also, as a result of the fermentation process, these methanogens bacteria, they produce methane, and along with methane, they also produce carbon dioxide. So what happens is methanogens produce large amount of methane along with carbon dioxide and some small amount of hydrogen as well. And when you look at the composition of biogas, it has 65% methane and the remaining 35% almost is carbon dioxide, and there are very minute amount of other gases, so which is like almost negligible. So that is how the biogas is formed. Now, this biogas is also termed as gober gas. Now, the name is quite fascinating. So, you might be interested to know why is it called gober gas. What is gober basically? Gober is the Hindi term for cow dung. Now, it has a relation, it has a very close relation with cow dung, and that is why it is called gober gas. So, let us quickly look at it. So, why is it called gober gas? Now, the excreta of cattle, which is called cow dung or gober, is rich in methanogens. So, the gober is rich in methanogens. And who are methanogens? Methanogens are the bacteria which help in the production of biogas. So, that is why it is called gober gas. Now, we already saw that these methanogens are present in the stomach of cattle. So what happens is a lot of cellulose is present in the food of cattle, because what is the food of cattle? They generally feed on fodder, and it is rich in cellulose. Therefore, cellulose is present in the stomach of cattle, and these methanogens are also present in the stomach of cattle. So cow dung, which is produced as a result of ejection from a cattle's body, this cow dung is extremely rich in the in these bacteria, that is in methanogens, and these methanogens in turn help in production of biogas. So if you look at the cow dung contains methanogens. Methanogen will produce biogas, and this will happen in the biogas plant. Now, this biogas which is being produced will be used for a variety of purposes, because it is a renewable source of energy. So it can be used for cooking purposes, it can be used for lighting purposes. So there are a variety of ways in which it can be used. And then what happens? So if you see this biogas plant, again, once it produces these biogas, the same remaining things will actually help in the growth of the plants. Right, and these plants will again act as a food for the cattle. So it is like a cyclic process, and that is why biogas is termed as a renewable source of energy, because nothing is lost to the environment here. So nothing is there which can cause environmental pollution. So it is like it is kind of a cyclic process, so which helps in the, because in biogas plant, it produces biogas which has methane, carbon dioxide and everything. So as a result of that, it also helps the plants to grow, because it is like a source of energy for plants as well. Now when the plants grow, from the plants itself, the cows feed on plants, not only cows, the cattle I mean, feed on plants or on fodder. So again the cow dung will be formed, again biogas will be formed. So it is like a renewable source of energy.
Thank you. Please visit examfear.com for an easy 4-step learning process absolutely free of cost. Watch video lessons, ask questions, refer notes, and take an online test. Thank you once again.